On behalf of the City of Savannah and Hospice Savannah, our community's legacy hospice, I warmly welcome you to the 29th annual Tree of Light. Normally, we would gather together, but this year, due to the extraordinary circumstances we are facing, we are meeting virtually, keeping the faith, but following the science. In the midst of the things that we have endured as a community over the last 9 months, I particularly thank the essential workers, first responders, and healthcare professionals who have gallantly and purposefully served our community during this pandemic and have served us often while placing their own needs secondary. Thank you. COVID-19 has made it difficult and in some cases impossible for families to gather together to celebrate lives and to mourn losses. These very necessary gatherings were not possible for the health and safety of all involved. As someone who has lost beloved family and valued friends due to COVID-19, my heart goes out to everyone who has been touched by COVID-19, everyone who has lost a loved one, or anyone who has been unable to attend funerals and memorial gatherings because of it. I am thankful that Hospice Savannah is providing this opportunity to process our grief, to be together, and to find hope and comfort. The bereavement counselors at Hospice Savannah continue to offer free support to any grieving child, teen, or adult in our community, and understandably, they are busier than ever. After such a difficult year of loss and pain, Hospice Savannah wants to provide this opportunity for everyone to find some solace and support. What is particularly important to me is that while hospitals, nursing homes, and assisted living facilities have barred visitors, the hospice inpatient unit on Eisenhower Drive has maintained permitting 2 visitors per patient because we believe that no one should be alone at the end of life. Everyone deserves to have someone to hold their hand as they transition from here to eternity. The light still shines, so let your light shine. Welcome again.
Hello, my name is Derek Zimmerman, and it is my privilege to serve as the board chair for Hospice Savannah. On behalf of my fellow board members, our amazing volunteers, and our incredibly caring and professional staff, I would like to welcome you to the 2020 Tree of Light Ceremony. Normally, we would gather together at the Demery Center for Living to express our shared love and support for each other. Obviously, this year presents special challenges, but I'm grateful you could still safely join us for this year's virtual event. Losing a loved one can be deeply affecting, and I would expect only more so when set against the backdrop of a global pandemic. If you have recently lost a loved one, I hope this time together might provide some small measure of comfort or relief in the days ahead. More than anything, in a time of social distancing, please know that you are not alone. The Demery Center for Living is also the home for Hospice Savannah's Full Circle Bereavement Counselors, who offer free grief counseling and support year-round. They are here for you should you ever need them. Finally, I would be remiss if I didn't also recognize the generosity of tonight's sponsors and the many wonderful donors who support the mission of Hospice Savannah. They made tonight's event possible and help fund many of the special outreach and support programs that serve the needs of our community. Thank you all, and be well.
As a board member of Hospice Savannah, I want to send all my best to everyone out there. It's the time of year where we come together for a Tree of Light ceremony in which we raise money for our organization to help those grieving. But we know right now we're all grieving in one way or another. Losses continue to mount in so many ways, whether it's loss of job, loss of loved one, loss of understanding, loss of respect, loss of balance. We're all grieving together, and our organization understands what it is to grieve. So again, we want to make sure everyone knows we're here to support you in so many ways. As you know, Savannah Hospice has been here for a long time. We take pride in the great commitment we continue to give to the community. And we understand today is different than any other day for so many reasons. So we continue to be with you during this time of loss. We continue to be with you as you grieve. And we also invite you to contact us anytime if there's anything you think we can do to help you. We are one community, one United States community, one Georgia community, but also, very importantly, one Savannah area community. And we're here for all of you.
I remember back in March when the Tenenbaum family first reached out to me, and everything was very unknown with what was going on with COVID. They were, after all, the first family to succumb to this disease, and it hit them the hardest because it was both mother and father. They needed help for Laura Lee, and we didn't have PPE that was necessary. We didn't have even knowledge, the training that was needed to treat this disease. But I knew in my heart this wasn't even a strategic or a intelligence decision. This was about looking deep and doing what the community needs, meeting the community where their needs are the greatest. And right now, back in March and continuing on, this is what we're facing with COVID. They needed support. They needed someone to come to their home. They needed someone to talk them through this time and continued support for what was to come. And Hospice Savannah was going to be that place for them. It is my privilege to be a part of a memorial gathering that honors them, that honors the entire family for what they have triumphed through and the grief they continue to face. And it is a privilege to speak with them about their experience.
Thank you on behalf of my whole family for having us here to tell you a little bit about what we've been going through. As you can imagine, it's been surreal and difficult. The unprecedented circumstances have compressed the timeline in a sense that, you know, it doesn't feel like it's been 6 or 7 months since my parents died. I think the funeral was delayed 3 months. So that was already a strange timeline. And now just being kind of suspended in the middle of this weirdness that we live in has made it sort of unable to totally move on to just back to regular life, because there is no regular life, so to speak. It was obviously very startling to lose my parents within 5 days of one another. I will say, with a little bit of time passage, there are some positive things about it that we've all come to understand. You know, they were married almost 61 years. So I personally had often dreaded a little bit the time that was going to come where one of them was going to have to live without the other. So we don't have that problem. So that's actually, you know, a little silver lining in there. Particularly for my dad, he didn't suffer at all. He was healthy and went into the hospital and, was having some trouble breathing, but he said, "They're going to put me on a ventilator." He sent us a text. "Could somebody please bring me a phone charger?" And that was the last we heard from him. So at least he was not cognizant that, you know, what was coming. So that was also comforting to us. Mom, she was in the hospital when Dad died, and I don't really know why they decided to send her home. Maybe just a humane decision to let her die at home. I was there along with one of my sisters, and we sat with her for a few days until she died. And hospice really made that possible. I honestly don't know what would have happened without hospice. We called when we found out they were sending her home. We called sort of begging because it was early on in the pandemic. And, you know, I think the first answer was, yeah, we're not really doing that. We don't have the right PPE. We're a little worried. And then Kathleen, I don't know if it was you who called back and said, you know what, actually, this is what we do. We've got to be there for our patients and we'll be there. And my sister and I both burst out crying at that because we felt pretty helpless.
I offer you two quotes this evening. One is by the French theologian Teilhard de Chardin, who said, "We are not human beings searching for a spiritual experience. We are spiritual beings having a human experience. We are eternal, and we celebrate that." And then the second quote is by Henri Amiel. "Life is short, and we don't have much time to gladden the hearts of those who travel the way with us. So be swift to love and make haste to be kind." Amen.
So a dear friend's daughter reached out to me. She knew that we were very concerned about mother being in the hospital alone and dying alone. So she reached out to me and said, "Well, Michelle, Julia DeLoach's daughter, Dr. Kathleen Benton, is the CEO of Hospice Savannah, and she may be able to help you all to see your mom in the last hours." So I reached out to Julia DeLoach, who connected me with her daughter, and she was our gift. She provided my brother and sister and I the opportunity to spend those last few hours with mom, to comfort her, to share with her how much we loved her, and just to be there to say our goodbyes, because we were haunted by the fact that our mother could possibly die in that hospital room. Yes, surrounded by caring nurses and physicians, but that was not her family. And to think that she would die without us being able to just tell her it was okay, you know, and encourage her that we were all fine, you know, and that it was okay to leave us. So we had the most wonderful opportunity. We didn't arrive here until about 7:30 that evening of her death. And the staff here was just so wonderful, because we were here after hours by the time mom was transported here, and they didn't rush us. They allowed us to stay as long as we felt the need to, and it was so amazing that the way it all happened, because we weren't home probably half an hour, and that sweet, sweet nurse Brenda that took care of mom called and said that mom had passed away. So if it had not been for Dr. Benton and for the care provided in this wonderful facility, I think we would be haunted for a very long time, not being able to say our goodbyes to mom. So it was a gift that we will always cherish.
When the rhythm of the heart becomes hectic, time takes on the strain until it breaks. Then all the unattended stress falls in on the mind like an endless, increasing weight.
The light in the mind becomes dim. Things you could take in your stride before now become laborsome events of will.
weariness invades your spirit. Gravity begins falling inside you, dragging down every bone. The tide you never valued has gone out, and you are marooned on unsure ground.
Something within you has closed down, and you cannot push yourself back to life. You have been forced to enter empty time.
The desire that drove you has relinquished. There's nothing else to do now but rest and patiently learn to receive the self you have forsaken in the race of days.
At first, your thinking will darken and sadness take over like listless weather. The flow of unwept tears will frighten you. You have traveled too fast over false ground. Now your soul has come to take you back.
Take refuge in your senses. Open up to all the small miracles you rushed through.
Become inclined to watch the way of rain when it falls slow and free. Imitate the habit of twilight, taking time to open the well of color that fostered the brightness of day.
Draw alongside the silence of stone until its calmness can claim you. Be excessively gentle with yourself. Stay clear of those vexed in spirit. Learn to linger around someone of ease who feels they have all the time in the world.
Gradually, you will return to yourself, having learned a new respect for your heart and the joy that dwells far within slow time.
Oh, Danny boy, the pipes are calling. From glen to glen and down the mountainside. The summer's gone and all the roses fading. Tis you must go and I must bide. But come ye back when summer's in the meadow, or when the valley's hushed and white with snow. For I'll be here in sunshine or in shadow. Danny boy, oh Danny boy, I love you so. But if you come and all the flowers are dying, if I am dead as dead I well may be, you'll come and find the place where I am lying, and kneel and say an Ave there for me. And I shall hear the soft you tread above me, and all my grave shall richer, sweeter be. For you will bend and tell me that you love me, and I shall rest in peace until you come for me. Danny boy, oh Danny boy, I love you so.
Hello, my name is Cheryl Millens, and I'm Artistic Director of the Savannah Voice Festival. and we are very pleased to be in partnership with Hospice Savannah.
I'm Maria Zuvis, Executive Director of Savannah Voice Festival, and indeed to be part of the Tree of Light ceremony is such an honor and a blessing for us to be able to offer our music this evening in a time of healing and memorial. Voices That Heal is a program that was established with Hospice Savannah, and indeed we are the artists in residence with Hospice Savannah to help people with palliative care, to offer healing through music. Music is often a place where we go for solace, and tonight is testimony to that. So we're very proud of the programs that we have where we can help families and those who are in hospice to find some comfort through music. Now tonight, our form of prayer is definitely represented in the two pieces that we're going to offer next. It is from Michael Ching's Alice Riley, an opera commissioned by the Savannah Voice Festival. It's the Lord's Prayer with Liz Lang singing.
And we will then hear Jessica Fischenfeld singing the Kaddish by Maurice Ravel.
Good evening. Thank you all for being here with us tonight. On behalf of myself, my colleagues Barbara Moss and Elizabeth Broadhead, I welcome you to our candlelighting ritual. In a moment, we will be lighting these candles in honor of your loved one. But before we do that, I'd like to share a story. A lot of people ask me why the love candle isn't the last one we light. Instead, it's the hope candle. And that's because the love we have for our loved ones is with us always. But sometimes hope leaves us. And it's really important to hang on to hope, especially now during this pandemic. So as we go through this ritual, think about things in which you have hope for. Hope that healing will happen every day as we move forward. Hope that the world heals itself of this pandemic. And hope that we can all live in peace.
As we light these five candles in honor of our loved ones, we light one for our grief, one for our courage, one for our memories, one for our love, and one for our hope. This candle represents our grief. The pain of losing you is intense. It reminds us of the depth of our love for you. This candle represents our courage to confront our sorrow, to comfort each other, and to change our lives. This candle is in your memory. The times we laughed, the times we cried, the times we were angry with each other, the silly things you did, and the caring and joy you gave us. This candle is the light of love. Day by day, we cherish the special place in our hearts that will always be reserved for you. We thank you for the gift your living brought to each of us. And this candle is the light of hope. It reminds us of love and memories of you that are ours forever. May the glow of the flame be our source of hopefulness, now and forever. We love you.
Here to guide you. Now you're on your own. Only me beside you. Still you're not alone. No one is alone. Truly, no one is alone. Sometimes people leave you halfway through the wood. Others may deceive you. You decide what's good. You decide alone. But no one is alone. Mistakes. Fathers, mothers, people make mistakes, holding to their own, thinking they're alone. Honor their mistakes, everybody makes one another's terrible mistakes. Witches can be right, giants can be good. You decide what's right, you decide what's good. Just remember, someone is on your side, someone else is not. While you're seeing your side, maybe you fall. Come out right. right now. We can make it so. Someone is on your side. No one is alone. No one here to guide you.
From all that you've been through, as we all have experienced hard times recently, even harder than ever imagined or expected before. But now, let your heart be renewed. Know not just that everything will be all right, note that everything is all right now because of your faith, because of those who love you, because of those who surround you and will assist you through every trial and tribulation. So this is a great time. It's a great time to grow and to learn from everything that we've gone through, that what you're going through and what others have gone through will at some point grow us to a point of joy and peace.
Shemir Ro.
What we want you to know is that we are here to be the collective response for this community and our national community. We understand that there has not yet been that response necessary to help people through a very troubling time with grief. This has been different for everyone in each experience, and each experience is very unique. You have seen all of the resource support that you can reach out to, and please do that. But we will continue to offer more. Right now, we are planning an event in collaboration with the Savannah Voice Festival. Voices That Heal will air at 11 a.m. and 7 p.m. on Tuesday, December 15th. That is another opportunity, a healing experience for those who really need to address their grief. Beyond that, please know, to our nation, to our state, to our community, we are here for you. Hospice Savannah is reaching out and will be your support through COVID-19 and beyond.
To that rock I'm clinging.